Take care of yourself and mind what I said. Everybody promise that's made has got to be kept. When you announce something that's serious business. So fight it out with the wind and the rope out there and keep your pledge, because if not...
Because if not, it'll be disappointing little Carlo, huh? And Carlo will never come back to watch all my nice crossings. Now, wouldn't that be a pity?
Nobody will come. Not a soul. Because I'm going to tell them about your swindles. Is that clear?
Good night, Carlo. Listen, come again some other time, but now go.
I want to show you this book.
What? The Bible, huh? You wouldn't be a Mormon, would you?
It isn't the Bible. It's a book on gymnastics.
Let me see.
I'll show it to you. Contains every manner of exercise to strengthen the legs, the arms, the chest, lots of illustrations too. The shoulders, the arms, the wrists. It includes every exercise imaginable for every one of the 385 most important muscles of the human body. In the first section, you have the toning up of the limbs and the large muscle groups, generalized gymnastics, nothing out of the ordinary. Second section, a muscle-by-muscle breakdown. Here's the triceps, for example, before the muscle-building program. And here it is, after it's complete. Quite a difference, right? Yes, indeed. And so on and so forth. Every exercise conceivable for each and every part of the human body. What do you think?
Price on this?
Not much. I'm giving it to you.
What?
It's no use to me anymore. I know every exercise in it by heart. Now you can use it. You need it.
I do.
Don't you think it's a good book?
Yes.
It's yours. I hope it's useful. If you wish, once you've read the book, we'll talk about it. Good night.
Wait a minute. Listen, tell me.
Yes?
You say you've watched every one of my crossings.
I have.
You think I'm not doing them well?
It isn't that.
You think I'm getting weak? Slack?
Commercial.
What?
Commercial. Too much sensational hocus pocus. Last week's crossing, for example, the bow and the wave to the crowd. You want my honest opinion?
Let's hear it.
Not worth a damn. You only waved because you couldn't help it.
Huh? I waved to salute my audience, pay respect to my faithful followers, and they loved it.
Oh, please. One knee goes up to support the balancing pole, while the arm is resting, waving to the crowd. And then the other cramped arm gets a good shakeout while stupid women are fainting right and left.
Listen, young man!
And that blindfold stunt. We know just how blind that blindfold is, don't we? Not blind enough to keep us from telling one colored marking from another.
Look here, boy! Are you blonde, man? How dare you come in here to give me a lesson on how to cross NIAGARA? I don't know why I put up with all of this.
I'll just tell you, you're the bravest man in the world.
Well, am I the bravest man or not?
I don't know if you are. I haven't met all the brave men in the world, so I really can't compare. But what I'm saying is that you've got to think of something that will really put your strength and courage to the test. All those stunts, they're all right for the masses, but you're not really proud of yourself, are you?
Proud? Of myself? $1,800.
Not bad.
So, according to you, what is
dancing pole.
Have you gone mad?
But that's what I brought you the book for.
Oh, well, thank you. I'll read it very carefully. Every time simpler, freer, lighter. But don't despair. Not all is lost. You still could, believe me. Someday you could step off the rope and get to Canada through space, without the pole, light as a feather. You'd become a bird. Sprouting wings, are you? I knew it the moment I much farther to the gyro, how much farther to the anchor point. You think of the wind, your arms and legs, whenever necessary, not always. And you struggle against thoughts of...
What? You don't ever think you'll fall, do you?
No. Never. Never. What gets into your head out there is images. People you've known, things they've told you, they rush into your head so vividly. You hear voices, talk back to them. Voices, music. Sometimes you sing.
Happy.
Yes. So I take my time. That's why I stop. It's not always in resting, like you think. Fantasies, too. Time. You see. Time is different out there. Time is slower. Not too often, mind you, but there are moments when I can feel that time is slowly stopping. It stops. I'm surrounded by a kind of infinity. It's very still, silent. I can hear the silence. I can feel tickling my veins. A kind of laughter from deep inside, as if my blood were bubbling. An incredible joy. And everything around me is warm and exciting. And I want to explore it. I want to get off the road. I want to...
Yes?
Jump into it. Jump right into it.
Yes!
You have no idea what it's like. Suddenly, I don't want to anymore.
Of course
this
not.
Desire becomes frightening. So I concentrate, grab onto the rope with my toes, and push onto the anchor point as fast as I can, and jump to the ground half dead. Relieved.
But one day, if you really set your mind to it, with my method, you'll...
Fly into space!
Yes!
And turn into a god!
You can do it!
The madness of it! Try to give up on all those phony stunts. Stop frying omelets and things. Do something that will really... You know what I'm talking about. The crowd will cheer just as loud. They'll pay just as much. They don't know anything. There won't be any cheap tricks.
how was it possible? Those are the only things worth trying. Anything else is just a farce.
Fine.
You'll keep the book then?
Yes.
Good. Thanks for the talk. Think it over about flying. You'd already had the idea. Maybe it isn't that crazy. Good night. How come so friendly all of a sudden?
How did I find you? Let me see. I looked in the classifieds of the Daily Gazette under scientists. Carlo, that's all.
Seriously now?
I spent some time asking around town. They finally realized who I meant. Oh, the boy who's writing a book about blonde.
Who told you that?
What?
It's a low-down, shame-faced lie.
Sad.
I wouldn't dream of writing a book about you. To me, you're only a hobby.
Is that so?
I mean, I'd write a book about tightrope walking from a scientific point of view. I'm interested in the possibility of man being able to fly, as anyone with half a mind would be. But you, as a person...
Nothing, huh? One way or the other.
You've said it. So... What's the big appointment all about?
I have a proposition for you.
Professional?
Yes.
So, make...
I want you to think it over. Very carefully.
Don't worry.
Serious?
Cross Niagara with someone on your shoulders, and I'm that person.
You missed it.
It's only logical.
Why?
Makes lots of sense, don't you think?
find it sensible.
Of course.
Are you sure?
Much more than you are.
Very well, then. Business. Normally, a partner will receive...
Two balancing poles or only one, for you?
Only one, of course.
I'd rather have two.
Absurd.
Listen, I'm not interested in becoming balanced.
That would never work.
I know what I'm talking about.
What? Just what do you know?
Are you married?
Not much.
Any kind of family?
No.
Me neither.
Are you an orphan?
Almost.
Do you know how fast that river flows?
22 miles an hour.
And the volume?
200,000 cubic feet per second.
Height at the temple?
200 feet. 165 feet at the lowest point, to be exact.
Angle of the slack?
32 degrees incline both ways. An upside down hill.
What's she made of, huh? So hemp,
Manila fiber, raw, 6 strands by 22 yards, right-hand lay, parallel threading, 1,100 feet long, 2 inches thick, 15 tons, tensile strength.
How many guy ropes?
12 pairs to the cliff on this side, 14 pairs to the Canadian side.
And in the middle?
300 feet without guy ropes, just hanging there, swaying. Training of a very special kind. This is groundbreaking stuff. You have to take this project seriously or else it's...
Carlo. Not...
I had a girl. But she went off with someone else. He had money.
She'd come and watch you go across with me.
No. She's stupid. Only interested in clothes and jewelry.
Yeah, she'd come all the same. Everyone does. You've seen for yourself. The Prince of Wales.
Not interested in all that.
So, what are you interested in?
Science. When did you think this up?
Yesterday.
Well, I'm glad. It's not the same as cooking omelets, is it?
No, but listen. If I could string a rope between the moon and the sun, I'd go across it without a second.
And without ever looking down.
Just enough to take it aside.
Moon and the sun. Not a bad idea, but you'd have to reach the sun first, of course.
Icarus didn't do too well when he tried that.
Icarus? A complete fool. Came tumbling down because he didn't listen to some sound theoretical advice. Wings of wax. Any fool would know the sun would melt them. Total stupidity. Plus, of course, the general backwardness of the era. Nowadays, you'd walk up there with a nice length of good manila rolled up under your arm.
Let's stick to Niagara. Shall we?
Yes.
Very well, then. Normally,
you'll be taking my life in your hands. My hands and legs, to be exact. Have you thought it over carefully?
You are talking to Blondin.
I know. But what if I fail you? One false movement of mine, and we both end up in the river.
So, right off.
That's easy for you to say. You're closer to the rope. You could always hang on if you got lucky.
That's true.
Hang on with one hand, wave goodbye to me with the other, and climb back up and continue on your merry way.
Well, no, it wouldn't be that simple, no.
Unless, of course, I hung on to your back so we could both fall together.
It could be, yes.
Maybe across Niagara with a man on your back either. So.
Carlo, there's something people call danger.
So?
You'd be scared out there.
Come on, Blondin. It's a beautiful stroll.
You're such a child. It's not a stroll. It never is. It's lots of hard work. Sweaty hands. And wondering if it won't be the last time ever.
Say goodbye to sweaty hands on this one. If I can find the correct method for training...
There's no method for training. There's no training with that damn. You can't rehearse this kind of thing. No matter how much...
I'm not talking about technical matters. My method...
The only method in the world is practice. There's a couple of basic principles. But the rest is practice. To get rid of your natural fear of heights. To learn to streamline your body against the wind. Or to learn to lean on it when you want to. Get a good stride going. And to know when and where to stop. Stopping in the middle can be fatal. You want to know your rope. As she will squirm under your feet. Every rope has a way of bouncing for you and against you and twisting. Yes! Twisting around itself like a spinning thread. Do you know anything about all this? You learn it on the rope. You learn it from me. I teach you.
Of course. Delighted. But that couldn't be everything, could it? I mean, there is experience on the one hand and science on the other. Don't take me wrong, I have the greatest admiration for your 30 years on the road. But I also trust the scientific method for training that I could develop. The best of both worlds. The perfect combination. It's a deal.
Forget about it.
Sir?
There's no crossing.
Why?
Because you're crazy! That's why. Because you're mad!
You really think that?
Yes.
Speak your mind, do you?
I do.
Why did you propose it to me then?
Because you're lied. I don't know.
Only because of that.
Carlo, please. You're just a boy. You don't know what you're getting into. I could be mistaken.
You are blown down.
So what? I'm still not even sure it's possible. It's your life at stake. I don't want
with
to be...
With my method, we'll be safe. If you just let...
You and your methods! No walk on the void. How can you expect...
It's only a question of...
Carlo, I'm not sure about you, but I'm not a suicidal maniac. Carlo, there's no way. The truth is, listen. I don't want to be responsible for your life. And you, yourself, you shouldn't trust anyone that much, ever. It's too absurd. Forget about it. Not another word about it.
Of course. I don't want to be responsible for you either. You could be dead because of me.
All right, then. So, forget about it.
Yes. Forget it. If you can. You mentioned something the other day. You said you'd like to owe your life to someone, anyone at all. You said it would be thrilling.
Yes.
Why?
I don't know. 6 years old. I was famous already. My picture on every newspaper in France. They might recognize me and come running back to collect their office royalties at least. Don't you think?
At least.
Yeah, they must have died by now. The type of walkers of the circus were usually couples with lots of children. It was in their contract to train me. I had to work for my room and board. I became circus property. Once a couple without children tried to adopt me, take me home with them. The circus manager wouldn't hear of it. Stands to reason. 12 years old, I was his gold mine. He made his fortune off me. I turned 18 and struck out on my own.
Why haven't you ever performed with any?
What about yourself?
What shall I tell you?
Your parents?
My father died. My mother married someone else. I live alone.
You ran away from home?
No. They fixed me up with a place of my own when I turned 18. To make a man out of me, they said.
And before?
Kind of boarding school in Rochester.
Are you happy? Living all by yourself?
Aren't you?
You have enough money?
Enough.
From your father?
Yes.
How much do you weigh?
120 pounds undressed.
No, it's just a question. This conversation...
Come on, Ben. Let's be frank. We both want to try it.
I said forget the whole thing.
And then you ask me how much I weigh? What did the last candidate want? 50%?
I haven't talked to anyone else about it. I just thought of it yesterday.
You have to do it with me. Because I want to do it, and I'll do it for free.
Why?
I don't care about the money.
You could die.
I know. Don't you think I know?
Why go on the rope?
You tell me why. You're the great Blondin. You explain it. That's only part of it. Blondin doesn't answer me. It would take both partners to create the proper balance, wouldn't it?
Wasting your breath.
Please, only that question. We're both out there, working together like one single happy person. That's the way it'd have to be, yes or no?
Yes, perhaps. But you're wasting your breath. You're not crossing with me. Nobody is. Get that into your head.
Precisely. I'm not crossing with you.
Right.
Nor vice versa. What's involved here is a bit complicated, so listen carefully. It's not you crossing. It's not me. It's not even both of us together. Someone else. We'll be creating a third tightrope walker. Half and half of each of us. He's the one who'll be crossing Niagara. That's why we need a kind of training that we can't even begin to imagine. It's got to be emotional and mental. We have to put together a strong, brave, well-coordinated guy, you see? And with no personality conflicts. And he's got to be a born fool. An absolute fool, because if he ever realizes what he's getting you and me into, he might run back halfway across, or even jump off out of simple desperation.
Or walk away through space.
You know what I'm talking about.
You're wasting your breath,
young
man.
He could be called Icaron. As a memorial to that other idiot with the homemade wings. Agreed? I'm only talking about the name. Icaron, all right?
Sure. All right. Icaron. He is not baptized.
You'd have to promise me a couple of things, though, first, before we start
learning. I haven't said I'll do it.
Neither have I. We only start training. We'll decide about crossing. we go across or not. That's my decision.
Fine.
I decide if we're Icaron or not.
Very good. Your decision.
Seriously now?
It's serious.
You agree to both conditions?
Yes. Both.
Do you solemnly swear?
I solemnly swear.
Very well, then. We'll get started tomorrow morning.
Bright and early.
Since I was 4 years old, watching you way up there. And now you do realize...
You always had this idea.
Yes. I was convinced if I pleaded hard enough, you'd take me across on your shoulders. I was dying to ask you. My father wouldn't let me. I don't weigh much, I'd say. Now, he wouldn't let me for the world.
When I was 4 years old, they forced me across. Crying and kicking and scratching whoever was carrying me. And wetting his back, I was so scared. 4 years old.
That's the reason why you are Blondin right now.
That's the reason you're a scientist. But there you are. Maybe we'll go across Niagara. Together. Someday soon.
Yes. My decision.
You're going to like this one. Chevalier Blondin, the Prince of Manila, the hero of Niagara, will now accomplish a death-defying feat of unsurpassed originality. Thousands upon thousands will be rendered speechless when the daring Frenchman arrives at the perilous point of no return and...
I know what's coming next.
Wrecks, beats, seasons, and cooks 1 dozen eggs.
Only 8.
Death's dazzling. Dozen eggs!
Only 8! Fake! Swindler!
The astounding result would be an asparagus omelet known throughout the old world as L'Omelette Blondin. What's this sizzling, savory confection he's ready? And while he is still suspended, over the void, the Prince of Manila will lower it with a rope
back at the American anchor point after having slipped?
Oh, you saw that, huh?
You didn't slip. You lowered yourself down.
Sure. They put those lies to some on newspapers. I checked everything before going on, of course. But suddenly, I'm on a swing, 200 feet high. I'm like the end of a pendulum. I lowered myself down immediately. I knew it right away. Sabotaged. All because of the betting that goes on. That's all it is to some people. Bets. Good thing the police frightened old Side runs over, huh? If he'd brought another gyro, that would have been it. It took me 45 minutes to return. Hands and legs, remember? The rope swinging about in the wind. I had to hang on, waiting for her to settle, the rope burning against my face. And then you have to get going again. Careful. The rope will notice you moving, and she'll begin swaying, swaying, and lashing. Huh? And you have to embrace her, once again, because she's going mad over Niagara, whipping about in every possible direction. Interminable minutes, fear.
Fear?
Of course. I'm a tightrope walker, not a human monkey. On a tight cable, I could dance you a polka, a can-can. But clinging to a bull with bit of licorice, everything depends on your muscles, and you don't know how long they will hold out. The experience of a lifetime isn't without doubt. They've changed the rules of the game on you. Suddenly, you're no more than an old chimpanzee, clawing at a wisp that's tossing in the wind. Hang on! Hang on! Hang on. And learn about fear.
Understood.
Yes, but yesterday, on the practice rope.
Do you want to do some concentration stuff? I think we're getting somewhere now.
The most amazing thing about that incident, arriving back to the anchor point.
They didn't crowd around you that time.
No, they didn't. They stood away from me and fell silent when I collapsed to the ground half dead. Silent. And then I heard something. Someone was singing. The Marseillaise, huh? Soon, all those thousands of people were singing. Well, not the words. They don't know the words over here, of course. But that whole crowd was shouting the music over and over again. And later I found out something I'll never forget. When I was hanging for my life onto that rope, everybody started betting I would survive. Huh? Astronomical odds, 50 to 1, 100 to 1, can you believe that? Of course, when I was that great blonde dame, high and mighty on my rope, the people bet thousands on my death. But those same people, when they saw me clinging to the rope like a sick little monkey, they only bet on my living. And the odds were against them, let me tell you. You know, a boy came up to me later and said, "How could we bet against you, Monsieur Blondin?" Maybe you don't realize it, but we all think a great deal of you. We don't want a great Blondin to fall for ever. And then he asked me for my autograph with the date on it. Sense when you think of it, but it's very moving all the same. Things like this, they should be natural. But they happen so seldom, they surprise you.
Blondin, let's get started. I'll try to make it a bit more difficult, eh?
All right.
Today, as we had promised, ladies and gentlemen, we proudly present the most daring double act in tightrope walking history, the Great Blondin and the Little Wonder.
Hey, what's that? You can't use that. That's my title, the Little Wonder, when I was five.
All right, all right. The Great Blondin and the Little Marvel.
That better now?
Uh-huh. We'll cross Niagara together. Yes, indeed. indeed, ladies and gentlemen, you heard it right. And you will be astonished. You will be astounded. You will be amazed, thrilled, transfixed. Misses, ladies, girls, keep your smelling salts handy because Carlo will make the crossing on Blondin's shoulders. Bravo, bravo. Popular marches on the brass bands. Ladies and gentlemen, Blondin and Carlo approach the anchor point. Blondin kicks the rope, testing it for tautness. Carlo looks into the crowd and waves as he picks out his innumerable friends and acquaintances. They're about to begin. The enormous crowd falls silent. Holds its breath. Blondin is about to take the first step forward. They're off! Blondin pushes on with confident strides. The wind is blowing, the music playing, the crowd is cheering, and the question is, can Blondin and Carlo keep their concentration? Yes, indeed they can, but what are we seeing? They're standing on space. They're flying over the furious rapids. No, they're flying upstream, up and over the falls. This is unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Blondin and Carlo have stepped off the rope and are now walking through space. No. Yes! No. They're coming back. Ladies and gentlemen, they're now back on the tightrope. Have our eyes deceived us? Can it be true that they went for a stroll through the skies above? We can hardly see them now. They're almost there at the Canadian bank. Push on, Blondin. Let's hear the music. The applause, the bravos, the madness of the mob. Hooray for Blondin, the hero of Niagara. Hooray for Carlo, the little marvel. What's going on?
Willie's bakery's on fire.
Right under us.
The ovens have fuel tanks.
Fuel tanks blow up, Blondin.
Oh, poor old Willis. Damn, there goes that bakery.
Whole building going up any moment now.
Have to take everything with us.
What a way to get distracted. Yeah. Clanging bells and all. What idiots.
Yeah. I was 5 in Lyon. This is all true. This is all lies. Amazing. I was 14 in this time.
Come on.
Hele, Tanya, Nicole, yes, here. Paloma, no, Paloma. Susanna. London, New York, Brussels, Sydney, Cairo, here.
Peking,
uh-huh.
Buenos Aires,
oui.
Bombay, London,
uh-huh.
Moscow.
Oui.
Moscow?
Uh-huh.
What's Moscow like?
Very big, very pretty. They don't speak Russian.
You don't say.
Even the little children, I swear.
The costumes.
The costumes.
Beautiful, the Moscow one.
Not this one. This one here, this one.
Oh, it's beautiful.
I used it in Berlin.
Blondin.
What happened?
Icaron.
Don't panic.
Don't you realize what's happened? I didn't get down.
Of course not.
Why didn't I?
Because you're mad.
You never realize a thing. The creature's ready.
Creature.
Icaron, aren't you glad?
Icaron!
Aren't you happy?
Yes, yes, at last! The chart! We're blowing up any moment now!
The map!
The map!
We're ready to cross!
If we don't blow up right now!
Oh, he's such a pessimist! We're crossing Niagara together!
Out the window!
Aren't you happy? Isn't it marvelous?
Yes, we'll talk about it later!
The tempest! Please, the tempest, we're coming down! We're crossing Niagara together!
I'm insane! I'm going on a tightrope with a raving lunatic!
No, no, Icaron! Icaron is the lunatic!
Yeah,
ladies and gentlemen,
right.
Presenting the newborn wonder of Niagara Falls, that wonderful madman, Icaron! it looks deeper over here.
It's the same 200 feet.
It'll be sunny and calm tomorrow. We'll have a good crossing.
Looks that way.
Blondin, tell me again. Explain it once more.
What do you want to know?
What's to be done if we're both left hanging out there, together?
We've worked on that. The crouch, you climb back on.
Then you get on your way. We're across fast.
Of course.
What do I do if I'm left hanging to the rope, alone?
Don't try to use your hands. Pull yourself up, hands and knees. Get to the nearest guy rope, slide down it slowly. Then you're safe. We've practiced that too.
But you, Blondin, what about you?
I'll be dead, and you'll be alive. But you must forget me.
If we both fall, what happens?
What happened?
Falling. What's it like? Mom?
I don't know.
Takes a while.
Yes.
And the wind?
Yes.
Water's cold.
Sure.
The river flows at 22 miles an hour.
That's correct.
You've been across Niagara 21 times. Tomorrow will be 22. 22. I've seen them all. Through my telescope. Never failed. One time they burnt a guy rope, every other time not a single hitch. You'll never fall into the abyss.
Never.
Because you're the best tightrope walker in the world. Isn't that right? If it isn't, you just say so.
I am.
But say so.
I'm the best tightrope walker in the world. I'll never fall into the abyss.
That's the truth. But what's more, Blondin, listen to me. You can also walk on the abyss. You might, tomorrow, even though you haven't trained for it much, at least a little bit, you could. Any kind of hitch, and you'll simply step off the rope. And I'll climb back up, and we can stroll away through space. Isn't that right? There's no problem, then. We're safe.
No, Carlo. That's not right. I cannot walk on the void. Things are the way they are.
But I told you to get into training so we could both be safer. You wouldn't take me seriously, but I had a whole method all worked out.
No, Carlo, no. Tomorrow there will be no magic. Two real persons, you and me, together.
No! No, Icaron. He's the one who's crossing.
True.
That man's a fool, eh?
He's making money.
Money? Come on, Blondin, what are you talking about? What does he care about money?
There's a Over $4,000 worth of tickets sold already.
What's the use of all those bills? Can he glue them together? Make himself a pair of wings? No. Icaron isn't crossing for the money. It's for something else.
Such as what?
Why is Icaron going across? Ask him. I don't have the faintest idea.
But why? What do you think?
How should I know?
Take a guess.
Well then, just to say something, I'd say Icaron, aside from being a born fool, that's got a lot to do with it. He's crossing because he wants to do something nobody has ever done before. It's part of it, I guess. Also, to see for himself something only you have seen. A complete, perfect void all around you. To be alone in the center of all that space. Except for a seagull, perhaps. On the other hand, Icaron is crossing Niagara because...
Yes?
I'm going across Flandin because I can't change my mind anymore.
We'll go see the impresario right away.
Not anymore, Blondin. I'm telling you, not anymore. Not since the fire.
If you don't feel all right about it, we'll postpone it.
No.
People have respect for that kind of thing. They don't think anything bad. They don't say anything. You have a perfect right not to feel well.
I'm going to tell you something. I got cold feet once already. Backed out in the most shameful way. I used to read a lot. I mean novels and other books. This happened 4 years ago. I was still in school. The other kids didn't like me much because of that, I think. Well, there's a novel. And in this novel, a small boy makes a bet with his friends, all of them older than he, that he will dare to lie down on the railroad tracks and let a whole train rush over him. He's worked everything out. He's measured the engine and the coaches. His friends don't believe he'll do it. Tease him about it. But the little boy plucks up his courage and he does it. Yes, he does. He faints underneath the train and runs a fever for a few days afterwards, but he does do it. This whole thing impressed me a lot. And I told about it in school. But they laughed. Said, fantasy stuff, a bunch of lies. Nobody would ever dare. To prove it was true, I'd yell and scream and contradict them. And one of those times I was all worked up. And I swore I would do it. I myself would lie down between the tracks, if there'd been any tracks, you see, because there was no railroad going through that town, of course. They laughed. All the more. Yeah, sure. He talks big because there's no railroad here. months go by, and they begin to lay down the tracks. And one fine morning, the trains begin to run. Nothing to do but go ahead with the boast. I had to get down there, my face all blacked up with soot and dressed all in black so the engineer wouldn't spot me and stop the train in time. All the guys from my school came along. I had to get down there on the ties and wait for the train. You know what? Guessed it. I jumped off the tracks when the train was still three blocks away. Bolted out of there, ran for my life all the way back to school. The boys running after me and screaming. I got to my room, locked the door behind me. They hung around a long time on the street and down the hallway. Drifted off much later. One by one, I didn't go out of my room for days. Pretended I was ill. When I finally did go out, I saw my name written all over the walls. What do you think?
It was the right thing to do. That was insane. The train could have run you over.
I measured everything. Worked it all out. 7.5 inches leeway. More than enough.
With any sudden movement on your part, a jerk, a start.
I've been training myself. Lying down beside every passing train. For 2 whole weeks. Lying down closer and closer until they began to enjoy the horrible noise.
All the same, the risk was so enormous.
No more or less risky than tomorrow. The same as then. It's all been worked out. The chances for success are very high. But still, then and now, first kind of madness. Unforgivable folly. And for what? To discover what? To prove what? So that nobody can ever again write on the walls that Carlo is a lying coward. Good enough reason, isn't it? Question of pride. Pride is important. But that's a negative reason. So that this or the other thing won't happen. You don't go across Niagara for that. You do it so that something will happen. That's what's important. What in the world will happen because we take such a pointless risk?
You'll be rich and famous, Carlo.
No, Blondin, you can have the money. Nobody's going to remember my name. You're the great tightrope walker. And Blondin, the legs are yours. Go across for Blondin.
I go across. Be out there.
So simple. Only the rope, the balancing pole and the wind to think about. You take those first steps on the rope, and it's as if your whole past had been erased. Your present is the rope under your feet, and your future that anchor point so far away. And then you take the second step to carry your life across. What you're taking safely to the other side is only the tiny, warm sparkle inside of you. When people survive an accident, some great danger, you heard them say, I was born again that time. Well, perhaps that's what you're after. You arrive at the anchor point, you've survived. You know it isn't fate that put you through that danger, but you yourself. So, you have given birth to yourself. And you're totally drained of everything that came before that crossing. And you're beginning to forget what you just did. Ah, look around you. And everything is new. You're not in my situation. You're young. Everything is still new to you. The tightrope is no use to you that way. There's nothing to erase. Ah, why should you go on the rope? It can't make any sense to you. We'll cut it off. It's that simple.
And your money.
They give it back. It doesn't matter. And for the next time, I'll think up some other gimmick. I'll go across on stilts or something. Any kind of stunt?
Is that all we've got here? A stunt?
No. No, of course not.
You want me to go across on your back tomorrow?
If you want to. Yes, I do.
You don't think I can make you fall?
No.
If you do, you just tell me and I won't come.
No need of that.
So...
What?
So why are you hesitating then? Why aren't you saying to me, forget it, Carlo. Come on, my boy, let's go drink a couple of beers, sing a few songs, eh? Forget all these doubts and misgivings. It's all been worked out and there's nothing could possibly happen to us. It's a sweet promenade into the void. Why aren't you saying that to me? Instead of convincing me or trying to convince me that it doesn't make a damn bit of difference if I go across with you or not.
You're alone now.
Not alone.
That's all. Your decision. You must come up with your answers.
Why?
Because it's better that way. For both of us. Do you see?
Yes. Say you convince me, and then I fall. You'd never forgive yourself. And if I only went across because you convinced me, that wouldn't mean anything to me. You are aware of your responsibility.
I am.
So am I.
But I am confident. I've been across many times. I've figured it all out. And besides, I'll be in company, you see. Happier and calmer.
We'll go across then. We'll go across tomorrow.
Good. So, something like that.
Fatal.
There must be a couple of things, Blondin. First
Blown down, what do? Explain it once more.
Get to the nearest guy rope. Slide down it slowly.
Are you getting tired?
I'm fine. You're very light. I hardly know you're there.
You can't hang on if you're lucky.
You don't want to. We can postpone it.
Wave goodbye to me with one hand.
More than half the distance, still.
Climb back up. Continue your merry.
We can still go back.
Train 3 blocks away.
My name written on the walls.
10 yards to go!
What?
Only 10 yards to the middle, the blue mark!
Yes!
Down the guy rope. I'll be dead. You forget me.
You're wasting your breath. You're not crossing with me.
You could die because of me.
Yes, but you're wasting your breath. I don't want to be responsible.
Forget it if you can.
I don't want to. You're just a boy. Nobody's crossing with me.
What's the matter, Blondin?
I'm crossing alone.
Blondin?
What will I do alone if you wave goodbye to you?
Blondin, what's the matter?
I never forgive myself. Never. Your responsibility. I'm alone out here.
What's wrong?
I'm alone out here. I'm not here. Vicaron is here.
The Blondin!
Who's likely? Who's guilty if you die? Who's the killer?
Blondin, what's wrong? When are you stopping? Please. Go on. Keep going. Don't stop. Anything wrong? Are we going to fall? Tell me. A cramp. Please. Are we going to fall?
I don't know.
What's wrong, Blondin?
I'm afraid.
Of what?
For you!
Blondin, you're the best tightrope walker in the world. I've seen you. The best, the only tightrope walker. The best legs, the best arms, the best brains. Blondin, listen to me. Go forward. You'll never fall, Blondin. Say it. Repeat it after me. I'm the bravest man in the world. Out with it. Shout it out.
I'm the bravest man in the world.
I'll never fall into the abyss. Repeat it after me, Blondin. You fool. Shout it out.
I'll never fall into the abyss.
Louder, Blondin, louder!
Never!
Very good, Monsieur Blondin. Now, just get moving again. One step at a time. We can't go back now. One step, that's all. You lousy coward. Blondin's a coward, yellowest coward in the world. One step, no more, or I'll throw myself off with you. Blondin, you son of a bitch. If you don't get moving, I'll kill you. I swear I will. Go on. Move. One step, Blondin. You're brave, Blondin. Tightrope walker, Blondin. Chevalier, Blondin. The Prince of Manila, the hero of Niagara. Just one step forward. Nice and slowly. One little step. Just one, that's all. Come on, Blondin. Blondin, one step. Little by little. Please. That's it, Blondin. The great Blondin. The one and only Blondin. One more step now. Come on, Blondin. don't be a fool, will you? Stopping in the middle, right in the middle. You should have changed your mind earlier on, but right in the middle is plain stupid. We're there already. We're almost there. Step over the blue mark. It's only one little step away. Step over the blue mark and we're in Canada. Step over it. Come on, step over it. That's it. Now we're really on the other side. Isn't that right? You can rest now. It's all right. Show them now, Blondin. Ladies and gentlemen, the hero of Niagara. Now, we're all set to shoot along that tightrope you see in front of you. Can you see it? Come on, Blondin. Look up or you'll fall asleep down there and then we've really had it. Look up, old friend. Look at that tightrope so lovely and taut. That's it. Look at the sky. How blue it is. How bright. Look out in the distance. The feverish mob on the Canadian side. 10,000, 20,000 people. And the band. Can you see it? Can you spot the tuba? How it shines. White uniforms. That speck of white on the hillside, that's the band. Come on, Blondin. Perk up, old friend. Cheer up. Blondin, you're the most solemn and humorless tightrope walker in the world, I swear. Come on. I'm getting fed up of being stuck out here so long. Maybe I'll have a little nap. Let me know when we get to the Canadian side. I don't want to miss the triumphant arrival. See you later. Don't forget to wake me up.
Carlo, Carlo, listen. I'm going on now.
You are?
Yes.
I'm hungry. You haven't by any chance got an omelet around somewhere, have you?
No. I'll bring the stove along next time if you want.
It's a deal. Let's get going, nice and quickly now, all right?
Fine.
You're the eighth wonder, Monsieur Blondin, the best tightrope walker in the universe. No doubt about that. Blondin, you really could walk on the open space. No, come on now, seriously, don't you think it's possible?
I don't know.
Because look, didn't you feel that you were resting on the air a bit? That the wind was holding you up, pushing you on?
Yeah.
You're a bird, Blondin. The way you walk along that tightrope.
Tightrope walker since the age of five. What do you want?
Since you were five. How many performances have you done, do you think?
No idea. Never kept count. 3,000.
And right this moment, ladies and gentlemen, Blondin is about to complete the most fearless and flawless feat of his sensational career. Now there's scarcely 60 yards to go, and this exceptional man will have set an unsurpassable milestone in the history of world high wire walking.
Carlo, that's all. Carlo. They fixed me up with a place of my own to make a man of me. A place of my own. Carlo, without the S. 18 years old, just barely. I bolted out of there when the train was 3 blocks away. The question of pride. Pride is important. What's your name? Carlo? Carlo what? Brave Carlo, little Carlo. You saved my life, Carlos. You saved my life.
Blondin! You can hear the music!
Calm down, you lousy coward. Move, stupid Blondin. Prince of Manila, hero of Niagara. Cheer up, friend. Cheer up, my friend. Friend. Carlo, you saved my life.
And as I speak to you, ladies and gentlemen, there's only 35 yards to go. Come on, Blondin. Hurry it up now, long strides. We're flying now.
Carlo, I once told you it would be thrilling to owe your life to someone. Do you remember?
Yes.
It is thrilling, Carlo. You want to know why?
Don't be so crazy, Blondin. I was saving my own life. You were planning to fall all by yourself, eh? You selfish bastard.
You saved my life, Carlo. Thank you.
thank you. I'll never forget it.
Because you've got a long way to walk, Mom, man. You've got to walk through space, up to the sun. I'll get you in training with my method. And if you like, I'll come with you two.
You're a madman, Colonel!
We'll go up walking, Blondin. Walking through space. We'll go walking without the tightrope, all over the sky. We'll go together, Blondin, walking forever. Do you want to?
Yes!